guess what Nev left in the back of the van?
To place in front.
Yeah, I know. Hey, hang on. Nev dropped a lot of acid in the 70s.
You'd never know.
He's got a brilliant sense of humour.
Yeah, he must have to have sold you that van.
No, I've just taken it out for a run. It's had the camshaft shaved.
Oh, what a bastard.
No, that's good.
Oh, yeah, sorry. I thought you said he'd shafted the camera shave.
Do you reckon I should tub it and whack in a tunnel ram?
Can't do any harm, can it?
Yeah, it's got to be impressive for Deborah, though, you see. She's given me a really hard time in the hall this morning.
Ah, that'll be PMT. Dorothy's just the same. One minute you're cuddled up on the sofa watching the clothes show, and the next she's coming at you with a bread knife.
Yeah. No, she caught me opening her mail.
Oh.
You reckon it's Dorothy's hormones, do you?
Well, to be fair, if I swelled up like a watermelon once a month, I think I'd get a bit annoyed.
Didn't she say something about you irritating the crap out of her?
No, it's not that. We're solid as a rock. It's our third anniversary tomorrow.
Oh, since you met?
No, since we first had sex. Well, both, actually, come to think of it. We're at this party, and basically she just couldn't help herself.
Why? Did you shove a load of lager down her neck?
I don't need to get a girl drunk to seduce her.
Yeah.
She was drunk, as it happens. We're in the back of this minicab, and I was sucking her earlobes, and she asked me in.
What for? Coffee, eh?
No, to get her earring out my tongue. It went right through the hole. Anyway, before I've had to beg with her or anything like that, we're at it, on the stairs.
Yeah, that's happened to me. Too wrecked to make it to the bedroom.
Yeah. Well, she was anyway. What can I do? I woke up in the morning, our mother's hoovering round us on the landing.
Parties, eh? Me and my mates used to have this rule that if you didn't get off with someone, you had to puke up on the host's sofa.
Mind you, I'm glad I'm past all that pulling stuff. I mean, it's no fun, is it?
I tell you what works, though.
Yeah.
You stand next to the best-looking bird at the party, right?
Yeah.
And you pretend you've got something in your eye, right?
Yeah.
Next thing you know, she's got her face so close to yours, you can see the wobbly bit down the end of her throat.
Yeah. Or you just get some fat bloke with a bottle of Optrex.
Mm.
Or you're at a party chatting up a bird, right?
Yeah.
And she's playing it a bit cool.
Right.
So you point out another bird in the room,
yeah,
and you bang on about how gorgeous she is.
Yeah.
And just let jealousy do the rest.
Yeah. That works, does it?
It did for this bloke I knew. He'd been chatting to this girl, got her jealous. After 5 minutes, I found them upstairs at it like a couple of Mormons underneath the guests' coats.
Brilliant!
No, it wasn't. It was my girlfriend. I couldn't go near my Parker after I'd seen where the hood had been.
Someone's dumped a hideous old van outside your flat.
Well, that's mine. I just bought it.
Sorry. Are we off?
I'll tell you another good one. We stand next to a good-looking bird at a party, right, and you make yourself look all pale.
Yeah, I'm not actually sure if Dorothy's going to be that interested in this
one, it's a good one, this one. Oh. And then you tell her you're suffering from this progressive wasting disease and she sleeps with you out of sympathy.
Oh, yeah, Gary tried that one on me when we first met. Was it you were dying of, Gary?
I can't remember.
I think you can.
Terminal verrucas.
That's it.
It's a great van, this, isn't it?
Yes, it's a great van, Tony. Where are we picking up Deborah?
Car park, level one.
Oh, tremendous. We have to sit around in a cross between a concrete coffin and a toilet, waiting for Miss Wet Dream.
Dorothy, is there some little problem you'd like to talk over with us?
You just drove over that man's dog.
Brick.
Dog.
Oh, for God's sake, cheer up, Dorothy, will you, please? I've got a nice little surprise for you later on tonight.
Does it involve baby oil tights and a stopwatch like your last little surprise?
Plenty of room in here.
Isn't that sign say out of order?
It's probably just kids mucking around. Nice and snug in here, isn't it? Excuse me.
Going down. Catfish dentures and rubber underwear.
It's not working. Open the doors.
No, I'll try again.
No!
What's happening?
Push the button to open the doors.
I did.
Oh, great. We're stuck.
Oh, dear.
Yeah. The tailgate's nice and low, you see, so you can get heavy objects in and out easily.
Fascinating.
I thought I might flare out the wheel arches and put wider wheels in. What do you reckon?
Absolutely.
Yeah. This is actually sound bodywork.
It's sharp about the van there, Tony. It's a stupid van. It's not even a nice van.
You don't think it's a nice van?
Yes, I'm sorry. It's lovely. I was joking.
I'll be stripping out all the
Stop
old carpets.
Stop talking about vans now, Tony, please.
Did I tell you about this motorbike I own once?
Oh, God! Oh, I'm sorry. Don't take it personally. It's just that I'm worried about me and Gary.
Don't worry, it's got an MOT.
Forget vans, Tony!
Okay.
I'm talking about my so-called relationship with Gary.
What's wrong with it?
Oh, I don't know. Just don't excite each other anymore. It's just going nowhere.
Yeah, but you don't want to go in for all that seduction nonsense anymore, do you?
Well, yes, actually.
What, one hand on doing the bra strap without dropping your kebab, that sort of stuff?
No, I'm talking about seduction, not drunken penetration behind a bingo hall. You know, passion, love and respect between two people that might love each other. Might that be possible within the context of an enduring relationship?
I'm sorry, you lost me after penetration.
Tell me about your van, Tony.
Those two are taking the time, aren't they?
Gary likes to think he's a careful shopper. He got banned from Boots once for testing the products.
I can imagine him with all them free aftershaves.
This is a barbecue, actually. I mean, the suppositories were bad enough.
What have you bought?
Oh, something for Gary. He's probably forgotten, but it's our third anniversary.
Oh, silk boxer shorts. Yeah. Girlfriend of mine once bought me a pair of these.
That's nice.
Yeah, except mine were nylon. I had so much static in my trousers, I kept setting off next door's burglar alarm.
Did you ever see that film where this couple got stuck in a lift and they had to huddle up so close together just to keep warm?
Someone super glued this together.
Yeah. And then it got so hot that they had to strip right down to their pants.
I am giving a dinner party tonight. It's important that I get out of here.
Sure.
Help!
I never touched you!
I'm trying to get us rescued.
Oh, sorry.
Well, it's your turn. No, it's your turn to shout for help.
Oh, sorry. What's the matter with you, Deborah? You've been a bit moody all week.
Oh, never mind.
Help! Help!
Help!
If it's PMT, you've only got to say, because believe me, you girls have my every sympathy. I'm surprised you get a wee bit tetchy every now and again. Is it true it feels like somebody stuffed your pelvis full of wire coat hangers?
No, Gary, it's worse. It's like being stuck in a lift with you.
Sorry, I don't understand.
Is anybody there?
Mind you, it's not all beer and Skittles being a man.
If women had to shave every day, it'd put a mild tummy ache into perspective, I can tell you.
It's not PMT.
What is it, then? Do you feel there's got to be more to life than this? Worried that you might not be using your body enough?
No. My area manager is coming for supper. I'm already worried about losing my job, and all the men I meet are stupid or ugly. Or both.
Well, at least you're not letting it get you down.
Look, I got this for Dorothy. It's her favourite brandy. But if you think it'll calm you down, why don't you have a drop?
No, thank you.
Huh? Don't mind if I do.
How long are we going to be stuck here?
Who knows? I've got something in my eye, Deborah.
Shut up.
Well, you may have lost your job, but at least we've got some nice tuck. Sardine.
No.
We could be stuck here for days. It's a good job I bought some nutritional food. Sorry, I didn't mean to say good job. Thoughtless. Still, this lift might be not working for us. Sorry. I didn't mean to say not working. I've done it again.
Oh, shut up, Gary.
Sorry. So, business not great at the restaurant, then?
No one's eating out these days.
Except us, hey? I'm sure you won't.
It will be the second time I've let my boss down, or she'll think I'm useless.
No, she won't. You're very, very, very clever. And don't you worry. There's lots of nice men out there.
There was a nice man coming tonight, actually.
Probably completely inadequate.
He's very witty.
Homosexual.
Divorce with two kids.
Oh, you don't want to muck around with a divorcee. All those kids running around on a Sunday morning just when you fancy a bit of parallel parking. Still, you've always got me.
And you've got Dorothy, Gary.
She'd understand. In fact, she's more or less encouraged me to explore my sexuality. Not in so many words, admittedly.
So, the only problem we have now is that I would rather die in appalling agony than sleep with you.
No, you're right. Dorothy's a lovely woman. What I possibly want with anybody else.
Exactly.
Terrific hair, Dorothy. I used to be able to sit on it.
Don't you mean she used to be able to sit on it?
No, it was much too short for that. I hope all this talk of Dorothy isn't making you jealous or anything. I mean, it'd be unfair to expect you to compete.
If this is one of your seduction techniques, Gary, it wouldn't get past a 16-year-old.
Oh, all right. Do you want to see what I got Dorothy for anniversary present?
What is it?
Well, I saw this little brooch in an antique shop, right? But I thought, no, that's a bit obvious. It's a little bit shiny and a little bit sexist. So I thought, well, I won't actually go for the obvious. All the small, I'll just get this. What do you think? Fantastic.
Lee,
lay out the blanket on the floor. So, do you want to take her for a spin up the A10 or try that again with me on top? Bloody hell!
Well, they're not at home and they're not in the crown.
My bed has just exploded.
So take me home, please, Tony.
Where do you think they could have got to?
Gary's probably dragged Deborah into a pub and she's fallen asleep during his funny story.
Well, why just stay with him if you don't get on with him?
I don't know. Maybe I feel sorry for him. When I first met him, he was dancing on his own at this party and he kept sort of dancing nearer and nearer to these girls and they kept sort of dancing further and further away. So he tried to edge them into a corner. But they couldn't escape. And then this slow record came on and he just looked so pathetic all on his own, leaning against the wall.
So you went and asked him to dance?
No. No, I suggested he put his trousers back on and go and sober up in the garden. I'll never forget the first time we made love.
Really nice, was it?
No. No, he kept singing Kumbaya all the way through. Kumbaya, my lord. Kumbaya.
Right then, let's do it.
Oh, terrific.
No, it's all right. I've probably just blown a little fuse. These things get a little bit cranky if you don't lavish a bit of care on them.
I know how they feel. Tony, well, between you and me, I'm thinking of telling Gary it's all over between us.
What I'm going to do here is pop the pink ball in the corner pocket and then screw the cue ball back onto another red. Now, the pink ball, once it's gone down, can be brought out again and put on its spot. But once the red ball is down, it is redundant.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to say redundant.
Thoughtless of me. What do you reckon your dinner guests are doing now?
I expect they've gone home, scratched me out of their address books. I mean, they're hardly going to believe I was stuck all night in a lift watching a drunk play snooker.
I've been thinking about the sleeping arrangements, and I reckon we should curl up like spoons. What do you think?
I'm not spending the night in here.
Why not? Could be worse. What do you fancy for breakfast? Branston pickle or the tin of peaches? They'll get us out soon. Don't worry. Did I ever tell you I had a serious wasting disease?
Help! What's moving?
Just don't rush into anything. Gary doesn't mean it. He's a nice bloke.
No, he isn't.
All right, but at least he doesn't take himself seriously.
Yes, he does.
Okay, nobody else does.
Well, where is he? He's about as reliable as this van.
What's wrong with this van?
Oh, forget it, Tony.
Look, don't worry. I'm sure there's a good reason for it. Maybe they've been in a horrific hit-and-run accident or And just think how considerate Gary can be sometimes. I mean, who was it last night who made supper for you, especially?
He didn't make me supper. He unwrapped a cod and chips.
Yeah, but he only wanted to come shopping today to get you a present. You remembered it was your anniversary, you know. Oh, Dorothy, he loves you. And with a love like that, you know you should be glad.
I suppose we're used to each other. I couldn't bear it if anything terrible happened to him. So, should we go and get a fire extinguisher?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, I suppose he is quite thoughtful sometimes.
Yeah, of course he is.
Where the bloody hell have you been?
But I went with a snooker table anyway. I hate snooker.
It's a marvellous game. It'll give us something in common. Or you could use it for putting things on.
Yeah, that's true, actually. We have this billiard table at home we use for that.
Yeah. We had a table we used to put things on, you know, household objects, and cups and plants and shopping and pencils.
Oh, yes, thank you, Dr. Jonathan Miller.
It's pretty amazing, this fan, when you think about it. One minute it's on fire, next minute it's up and running.
Only because we push-started it round the car park for an hour and a half. Do you like your boxer shorts?
Yeah, they're lovely. You're good to me, Dorothy.
Don't always rely on it. And Gary, you're supposed to wear them under your trousers.
It's good, this man, isn't it?
Oh, get out.
Right,
oh,
that's it, Tony. Go on.
Don't push! Tony, come back! Don't!